The reason I don't upload every week isn't because of a lack of recording videos. It's my editor, Wi-Fi. He is adorable, so clearly I can't fire him, even though he does spend all day pawing at the screen. His birthday's coming up, and I wanted to get him something he'd love, so I started experimenting with other apps like Fly on Desktop. Resounding success. Side note, modern displays are surprisingly scratch-resistant. Because I wanted to get actual work done and dedicate a monitor to just entertaining the cats, I hit up Craigslist for cheap displays. The DFW area is amazing for affordable PC parts and accessories, and I ended up scoring 4 monitors for a grand total of $20 off a day trader. Not the exact ad you're seeing on screen, but just to prove a point that it's possible for someone else to do the same. My 4 displays didn't have any HDMI ports, only DVI and VGA, but still, not bad. 3 of them still work a year later. At one point, I started toying with the idea of putting up a green full-screen image and moving the cursor around, so I'd have endless ways to incorporate Wi-Fi as the new main host of the channel. But you'd really only see the back of his head. YouTube's multi-hour relaxation video loops are surprisingly useful for humans and cats too, especially aquarium videos. So now that I had some videos picked out, I grabbed a spare Raspberry Pi, which is a $35 computer that runs off USB power, and started transferring videos onto the device. You could also just make a YouTube playlist of the same video several times in a row if you don't want to download anything. A familiar story to anyone who's tried to do something nice for their cat, you'll know it's never straightforward. I tried all 4 monitors, and he did not like any of them. He never once seemed to notice anything on the screen, trying multiple videos over several weeks. Literally, not once did he lock onto the on-screen video. However, he does love IPS displays, meaning all the monitors on my desk. Since recording these clips you've seen so far from months ago, we've also adopted Blu-ray, and she also only seems to care for IPS monitors. I've tried both portrait and landscape orientations using 3 different brands, and all of these IPS panels have the desired effect. They also both chase cursors on the living room projector that shines on the wall. The cheap Craigslist monitors are definitely not IPS displays, and since they can't entertain the kitties, they'll have to entertain humans in the form of future projects, such as a skee-ball machine powered by a Raspberry Pi, an emulator arcade cabinet running everything from original arcade games up to Nintendo 64, and my server rack for easy web interface access to a dozen other Raspberry Pis. Wait, what was the focus of this video again? Doesn't matter. I've linked Raspberry Pis and some cheaper IPS displays if you want to spoil your cats. I mean, they're cats, so they're probably just as upset as you are that you spend more time at home these days. Subscribe for more DIY cat toy experiments, 3D printing, and DIY Raspberry Pi /tech projects. And also, depending on how sharp your cat's claws are, you might want to pick up a sheet of plexiglass or acrylic to put over the screen of whatever you get for your cats. Just a thought.